Howdy folks, this is BlackServal, and we're back again to talk about feature focus of Jurassic World Evolution 2. In feature focus, we're talking about new features and mechanics to consider when acquiring and managing your dinosaurs and prehistoric reptiles. Here we have updated the process of acquiring and bioengineering dinosaurs in your parks. Extracting DNA from their fossils allows you to build out their genome and then create them in your hatcheries. While dinosaurs in Jurassic World Evolution had to be created one at a time, the hatcheries can now create and release several dinosaurs at a time, letting you populate your parks with more dinosaurs a lot faster than before. Okay, so we can create and release more than one dinosaurs from hatcheries. Ah, interesting. Now we can create dinosaurs faster than in the first game. Right, next is the process is split into two stages, synthesis and incubation. In synthesis, you create a clutch of eggs and can apply genetic modifications to tweak everything from dinosaurs' social traits, lifespans, and skin patterns and coloration. The results of genetic modification are revealed at the end of the synthesis stage, and your dinosaurs may have both desirable and undesirable traits depending on the modification you choose. In incubation, the dinosaurs are raised to adulthood inside the hatchery, and the dinosaurs can be released into your park. Cool! Now we can modify the genetic, but are this feature already have in first Jurassic World Evolution? I'm honestly like to not modify the genetics, but sometimes I found it really fun. What I like from these features are skin patterns, colors, and lifespan. Other than that, still cool, but it makes the dinosaurs look unnatural. That's just my opinion. I don't know what you say. Dinosaurs can also be released in groups from a single hatchery. So all the dinosaurs you engineered can start exploring their new world together instead of going one at a time. Another feature we're excited about is remote release, which lets you transport dinosaurs directly from a hatchery to a different point on the map. This lets you separate hatcheries and enclosures in case you need a little extra space for more dinosaurs. Yes, that was I expected. I was expecting this since Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. So cool, we can release dinosaurs in a group from a single hatchery. I mean, that makes the park can have a lot of dinosaur population faster. Remote release is the newest exciting feature I haven't expected before. So this feature, you can transport dinosaurs from a hatchery to a different point on the map. So if I already have a group of triceratops, but they were far away, and I want to create one more triceratop, but I can release it close to the herd by using remote release. Well, that's interesting. Alright, for the next is bioengineering. Isn't it the only way to get dinosaurs into your parks? Certain modes allow you to transport live dinosaurs into your park from the wild via remote capture and narrative events, and in some levels, there'll be wild dinosaurs in your surrounding area that you need to locate, tranquilize, and transport back to your facilities. Ensure your enclosure have everything the dinosaur might need in order to thrive. How you respond to these events is up to you, but they will certainly bring in dinosaurs that add something unique to your parks. Whoosh, finally it's confirmed. We're not just create dinosaurs on hatchery, but we can get dinosaurs from the wild and bring them to the park. I see Jurassic World Evolution 2 is a sequel to Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. At the end, the dinosaurs are escaped from Lockwood's mansion, scattered. Now in this game, we have a chance to capture them and bring them to the park. I guess this is the cheapest and fastest way to get dinosaurs than incubating inside hatchery, because it costs a lot of money and time to wait them full grown up to release. Love this feature and so excited. All dinosaurs have needs and requirements for their enclosures that you need to fulfill. You will need to provide food, water, and a comfortable environment in your park for your dinosaur to thrive. And different species have different needs. Okay. Dinosaurs will naturally create territories inside their enclosures based on their environmental needs. They will also seek to expand their territory if they are not satisfied with what's currently available. Territories are new feature in Jurassic World Evolution 2, allowing you to design more flexible enclosures. You will also need to put more thought into where you place your viewing galleries, as dinosaurs will roam around a lot more than they did previously. You're not guaranteed that they will stay in the same place for long periods at a time, especially if you have a big enclosure. Fantastic. Must admit, this game getting more realistic. So yes, dinosaurs in accurate ways, not far different with modern animals. They can create territories. Once they were released, they not just settle, but explore all the area and expand their territories. Don't get surprised if the guests can see them from viewing galleries because of huge space and the dinosaurs will roam. This feature is one of new behavior of the dinosaurs. Your dinosaurs will exhibit new behaviors and react to their surroundings. We've added new animation for when dinosaurs are resting, socializing, walking, running, hunting, and fighting, making them more realistic and natural. Cool. Carnivores suit for it will engage in pack hunts and show a more dynamic range of movement when taking down prey. Dinosaurs that are considered prey might be able to escape predators and continue living. After a visit from the park's medical staff, of course, wounded and sick dinosaurs can be treated in the field by the mobile veterinary unit, a new park team we're introducing in Jurassic World Evolution 2. Injuries, and will need to be treated at the paleomedical facility, we will have more to share about this at a later date. Alright, highly interesting. So the animation is different from the first game, and also the behavior, how they walking, hunting, socializing, etc. are totally different and improved to more realistic. When the carnivores hunt the herbivores, the result is not always success. There's a chance for the herbivores can survive but maybe heavily injured or fight back the carnivores. If there are any sick or wounded dinosaurs, they can be treated in the field by a mobile veterinary unit. The one we saw on the trailer come after a natural setup near a lake, or they can take to the paleomedical facility for rehabilitation until they can release back to the enclosure. The paleomedical facility may be the one show in the trailer and in this image. The one have a helicopter landing, and parking lot, and a small fences area, I think. Yep, I guess. If several dinosaurs share the same enclosure, their territories might overlap and you might start to see fights for dominance. Luckily, certain species get along better with others, letting you create peaceful enclosure by housing compatible dinosaurs together. There might even be bonuses to your dinosaurs and popular things. If compatible dinosaurs share an enclosure, something to look out for, park managers. Alright. Such an amazing features. Fight for dominance. I guess we can see this on species field guide, triceratops. Maybe not all dinosaurs could fight each other, but I think this could be happen on several dinosaurs like triceratops, nasutoceratops, stegosaurs, ankylosaurs, coelophysis, pachycephalosaurs, parasaurolophus, etc. To stay on top of the welfare needs of your dinosaurs, your ranger teams can link up to ranger posts that can be placed inside your enclosures. This will be visited by rangers when they are on patrols, letting them scan every dinosaur within the range of the post. You can still tax a ranger with scanning an individual dinosaur in case you need an update on how it's doing. Cool! We know the map of this game is huge than the first game, so it's really difficult to monitor the dinosaurs. But now there are ranger posts to help keep monitoring the dinosaurs inside the enclosure. Other than that, they can go out to patrol to scan every dinosaur whether they're sick, wounded, or else. Fascinating. So far, feature focus done really well. I'm impressed by this news and update. Hopefully, there will be more, and I'm excited for it. So, that's all my review and explanation about this feature focus based on Jurassic World Evolution forum. There a post like this, a news like this. I will put it in the link in the description, and we'll meet again on the next videos. I think it's about species field guide, Amergasaurus. The one we saw or appear on Jurassic World Evolution 2 live streaming. So we will discuss about it. We'll be talk about it later on the next video. So stay tuned. If you're new, subscribe to my channel and give it like to every content I make. I will be very grateful. And yeah, see you next time. Auf Wiedersehen.